This is the Darkflash DH360D, a sub $100 all-in-one liquid cooler from a brand you may not have heard of very much in the AIO market. Can this budget-friendly cooler from an underdog brand truly compete with the giants? You've told us you want to know, and we're going to find out right here, right now on Robeytech, after a word from our sponsors. This video is brought to you by our official Robeytech build mat. If you've been watching the channel for a while, you'll probably recognize it. We love these things. They're super thick and durable, and they're absolutely huge in size, measuring at 5.5 millimeters thick and 24 by 48 inches wide. This one that we have right here, man, this has been in the studio for like 4 years and it's still holding up great, no problem. We've also included all sorts of useful graphics showing different PC form factor sizes, including schematic diagrams and connectors you'll encounter probably during your PC build. Not to mention, there's plenty of open space for screw and tool organization. We designed it like this so no matter what skill level of builder you are, it could be a helpful tool for pretty much everyone. Now, you can find these build mounts for sale on our Newegg store, and it's a great way to support us directly if you enjoy the content we make. Thank you so much for your support, and let's get back to the video. When it comes to the sub $100 liquid cooling market, there are a lot of options, but the market and conversation tends to be dominated by a handful of major players like Thermorite and Arctic Cooling. But look closer and you'll find other coolers like the Darkflash DH360D popping up as alternatives from lesser known brands. Taking a shot in the dark with one of the most important parts of your PC isn't for everyone, but the DH360D's its specs, its price, and unique LCD screen make this mysterious AIO a compelling option that might be worth considering alongside established options from bigger brands like Thermorite and Lee & Lee. It does need to keep your CPU cool, however, so we picked this one up for ourselves to see just how well it performs and whether it deserves a place in your next PC build. Now let's kick things off by looking at its pricing and options and how they compare to what's already out there. According to the homepage, Darkflash offers the cooler in 240mm and 360mm sizes, each available in either white or black. However, in preparing for this review, we were only able to find the 360mm version even from Darkflash's own store. For clarity, the current model is also dubbed version 1.2, and from what we can tell, it appears to be the only version available for purchase. The differences are minor and include small spec upgrades to the fans and the screen, which now allow it to display three-digit numbers instead of two. Now, when it comes to pricing, the DH360D came in at around $90 on Amazon, with the black version costing a couple dollars less. That price puts it in competition with some other well-known options, like the Thermorite Frozen Warframe Pro and the Lee & Lee Galahad 2 Lite. Compatibility-wise, the DH360D is a lover, not a fighter. Unless you're heat, then it's game on. On the Intel side, it covers every desktop socket from LGA 1366 all the way up to LGA 1851. For AMD, it supports everything from AM1 to AM5, as well as FM1 to FM2+. So you're gonna be covered whether you're using an Athlon 64 or the Ryzen 9 9950X3D. The installation process is relatively straightforward and shouldn't be difficult for experienced builders. If you're a newcomer to the hobby, you'll definitely want to take your time and read the manual to prevent hiccups. Everything you'll need is included in the box, including thermal paste, which honestly is a nice touch. Now, if you're pairing this with an AMD CPU, you'll need to remove the hardware that came with your motherboard and replace it with Darkflash's own. It isn't difficult, but when you're on an AM4 motherboard or older, take some extra care when swapping the backplates. Dropping the stock mounting system makes room for four corner mounts, which is easier and leaves less room for gaps. This system is better for beginners and leaves less room for air pockets or inconsistent tightness. Now, installing the DH360D on Intel is also pretty standard. Darkflash includes a bracket and standoffs for each socket, so no matter which platform you're on, you'll have the same four-post mount for even pressure. The fans come pre-installed, but there is a bit of cable management required. Now, the DH360D comes with a fan hub, so you can connect all three fans to a single PWM controller, but there's also RGB cabling, the pump's power cable, and a USB cable. So make sure you manage your cables well, or you end up with a mess. Now, while we're talking about installation, you're not done after you install the hardware. With the DH360D, software installation is mandatory if you actually want the screen to work. Since performance and lighting are both handled by your motherboard, the software is just for display and it's almost painfully simple. It offers a handful of dropdowns to choose from, things like which core is actually used to display the stats, how RAM is utilized and monitored, and which units it will use for temperature. Although, honestly, Kelvin was left out in the cold, so it's kind of sad to see that. Now, there isn't a full-colored LCD for GIFs or animation, and there is no smart features. It's a segment LCD able to display simple characters like one of those reliable Casio watches you had in grade school. Well, maybe that was just me. But without the software, it just plain doesn't work. Now, the screen does have a couple tricks up its sleeve, though, like its ability to come off and reattach with magnets to quickly change its position, or that the display is actually longer than the pump head at roughly 4 inches wide, so there's more space for its extra numbers and easy legibility. It also comes with an RGB layer beneath the screen for a bit of underglow and a light ring around the head. Do you know what's even simpler, though, than the DH360D software? Hitting those like and subscribe buttons below this video and ringing the notification bell. While you're at it, head over to Robeytech Live and do the same thing so you never miss another great tech video. We've got plenty in store and you're not gonna wanna miss what's coming next. Now that we know what's happening on the outside, let's take a look at what's happening inside the pump. Darkflash doesn't reveal many details about its pump, but does share that it has a 9-pole motor with a large copper heat plate with a 2-in-1 impeller design for added durability. It can spin up to 3200 RPM, give or take 10%, which is about average for the price. Now, the radiator has a pretty standard thickness of 27 millimeters, but the fans bring the bling with bright LEDs within that light up the fan blades. And there are even infinity mirrors set onto the hub of each fan. Because you know what's better than RGB? Infinity RGB. Now, before sharing the numbers, I wanted to highlight that it wasn't easy to find the true specs of the DH360D's fans and pump. Depending on which site you look at and whether you're looking at text or images, the speeds and stats can totally vary on what's being reported. Now, we're pretty confident we have the airflow specs pinned down, but we test max speed for ourselves to put this one to bed. The fans can spin up to 2000 RPM and are rated to move just over 64 CFM at full speed. Now, if fan speed is a maybe, static pressure is a meh with a comparatively low rating of 1.5 mm H2O. For comparison, the Thermalright Frozen Warframe Pro is rated at 2.63 mm H2O, which is 42% higher, and the Lianli Galahad 2 Lite, which is like the top of our charts, is more than double at 5.1 mm H2O. Now that we know what the Darkflash DH360D brings to the table, let's see how it actually performs. As a reminder, all of our AIO tests are performed in nearly identical Intel and AMD PCs. Note on screen for details. All of this is done under the same conditions to keep data as clean as possible. Now we're gonna go through this pretty quickly, so feel free at any point to pause the video if you wanna make some notes. Starting with our Intel test bench under full CPU load, the DH360D averaged 86 degrees. This positioned it near the warmer end of our charts, right in between the non-pro Arctic Liquid Freezer 3 ARGB and the Asus Ryujin 3 Extreme. For context with its price competitors, the Lianli Galahad 2 Lite averaged between 78 and 79 degrees and holds a top spot for our CPU load performance, while the Frozen Warframe Pro averaged less than 1 degree warmer than the Galahad 2 Lite. So there is a bit of distance here. How does that translate to system performance? For that, we turn to our Cinebench test, and it's back to the middle for the DH360D. It earned an average score of 33,402 alongside the Lianli HydroShift 2 LCD-C360CL and the Trikes Panorama SE ARGB. Now, when we look at the power draw, we recorded the DH360D at the lower end of our charts, pulling an average right in between 233 and 234 watts under load. This sandwiches in between the Galahad 2 Lite and the NZXT Kraken Elite, though it would have been nice to see its CPU temps more in line with these two as well. Now, moving into our suite of real-world gaming benchmarks, the DH360D again landed toward the warmer end of our temperature charts with an average of just over 57 degrees Celsius, drawing an average of over 105 watts while in the process. While these results fell around the middle, it's worth remembering that the maximum temperature, the TJ Max for these processors, is still 100 degrees, so the Darkflash DH360D is still getting the job done with room to spare. Now, turning to AMD, the Darkflash DH360D performed better under load relative to the competition that we saw on our Intel test bench, maintaining its midline positioning instead of climbing to the wrong side of the leaderboards. It averaged 87 degrees, about 2 degrees warmer than the Frozen Warframe Pro, and about 4 more than the Galahad 2 Lite, but decent nonetheless. Does this newfound success translate into high performance in Cinebench? It does, and in fact, it has kind of a big rally, landing in the top 5. With an average score of 19,652, the DH360D finally besting the Thermalright Frozen Warframe Pro, but coming in behind the Galahad 2 Lite. Now for power draw, the DH360D averaged between 144 and 145 watts. Now when it comes to gaming on our AMD system, the DH360D held firm in the middle with an average temperature of just under 55 degrees. This positioned it next to AIOs like the Fantex Glacier 1 M25 G2 and the CPS PC Cooling DT360 ARGB. As for power draw while gaming, the DH360D averaged between 77 and 78 watts, which again, was smack in the middle. Overall, the Darkflash DH360D gets the job done when it comes to cooling, but how does it do when it comes to acoustics? During our gaming benchmarks, we measured noise levels just under 48 decibels. With the CPU under load, that increased to between 59 and 60 decibels. Most of the time, your fans should run closer to the gaming noise level, which is about the level of a refrigerator between cycles. 59 decibels is more audible, but comes as the quietest AIO we've tested so far at max speed. Now before rounding this out, we have one more data point, and that's the relative value. To compare the value of these coolers, we test a way that is objective and easy to understand. We do some fancy math, and it kind of breaks down like this. We start by dividing the MSRP by the difference between CPU thermal max, which is 100 degrees Celsius, and then average CPU temperature under load. This gives us a dollars per degree of cooling value, which we can then score and compare. We've come up with these scores using the data from our Intel bench and the pricing at launch, which means that the values will change over time. But now that you know how we do the math, you can basically see where things land today. With that in mind, the Darkflash DH360D earned a relative value score of 6.2, placing it in the lower middle or higher value area of our rankings. It's not the cheapest or highest performing, but balances both price and performance to deliver a well-rounded value proposition, although it didn't quite beat out its price competitors. With all that in mind, is the Darkflash worth picking up for your next PC build? While it may not offer the best performance or the highest value, the Darkflash DH360 feels safe. And that word, that kind of sums this whole thing up. It supports just about everything, so compatibility is safe. Its performance is safe for everyday CPU use, heavy workloads, and even experimenting with overclocking. Its installation could be quicker, but it's not hard, and with a bit of extra time, it's safe for just about any builder. And while it ran on the warm side in our Intel CPU load tests, it's worth remembering that these temperatures are artificially high. For the average user and even creator, what we saw in our gaming tests is closer to what you'll see in the real world. Our 14700K barely made the DH360D break a sweat. Don't get me wrong, if you're building a performance overclocking PC, the Darkflash DH360D probably shouldn't be the AIO you reach for. Record-breaking overclocking demands record-breaking cooling. But can you throw an i9 in here and turn the dial? Well, we didn't test that for this review, but the data points to yes, within reason. Even though the software leaves a lot to be desired, the trade-off is its simple, almost retro-feeling screen. There just isn't a lot out there with the same kind of style or pulled off as nicely as the Darkflash does. You know what, it's kind of the thing that you're either gonna love or hate. And if you do love it, choosing it based on style here is also safe. And we can now safely say that we've arrived at the end of this video, and now that you know our thoughts on the Darkflash DH360D, it's your turn. How do you feel about its segmented LCD screen? And does it offer enough for you to really compete with the likes of Lee and Lee and Thermalright? Let us know what you think down in the comments below. Now, while you're in there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this, either here on Robeytech or over at Robeytech Live. And if you want to continue the conversation, see if this is the right AIO for you or what you want to do in terms of PC builds and stuff, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. It's an amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts about stuff just like this. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, follow us at Robeytech on all your other favorite social media platforms. And if you made it this far, I want to say a huge thank you for sticking with me through this video. And I look forward to seeing you on the next one.